One, the one, the one, there is only one, and one dreams it is two.
No, no, there's only the wholeness, the one, and the one has a dream of form, and the, everybody here has a dream of the oneness.
I don't quite, there's only wholeness, and it also appears as though it's divided. In the dream, wholeness appears as though it is two, or the me, or the self.
Sorry, my English is not very good.
Self is wholeness, dreaming that it's a self.
No, my question is, we are all in, we are all one?
No, we are not. No, there is only one. There is no we to be one.
Okay, we are.
I know we would fondly love to be one, but unfortunately it isn't. Me always wants everything, including being at one. That's what most teachings are about. But there is only oneness. There is not two.
Yes, yes, that's my question. We are one. We are one.
How can we be one? Because we is something. There's only oneness.
May I?
Maybe it's your language. You go on. Oh, you have we being one. Go on. Maybe it's your language thing. It's a language.
I think
are we part of the one?
No. No, we aren't part of the one. This is. There is nothing that is a part of oneness, there's only oneness. This is a mystery, it's paradox. There isn't something that is a part of oneness, because then it would be another thing in oneness. There isn't another thing in oneness, there's just one.
And he wants to know if we are a part of the one.
No. No. There isn't something that is a part of the one. There's just the one. And within the oneness arises a dream of something called me or we who thinks or dreams that it is a part of the one. This is an illusion. This is the illusion that we are deconstructing. There isn't anything that is a part of the one, there's just one. The problem for me is that it divides everything into two. There isn't two, there's only one. It can't be understood. And it can't be known. After liberation, there is only unknown. Unknown.
I don't know about that.